We know the quality of Distiller's yard. Becomes our job to cut one from each side of this competition, being the legal and the outlaw side. We're going to start with Team Legal.
Trent, I noticed you didn't use any electricity or turning things. You just used the wood. Did a great job. The taste and the flavor, I think your blending skills were off the charts. The other criteria was we're asking you to hit 95 proof, and you came really damn close. 92.
Oh, yeah.
Outstanding. Michaela, I came in and I saw this machine in the back. I didn't know what was going on, but I'll tell you what, it absolutely changed the liquor. The distillate that I was tasting was really clean. It stood out. It wasn't covered up or masked. You had a hydrometer. So we're thinking about, she can't miss this, right? You were at 98, so really close. So outstanding jar.
Thank you.
GP, from where you started with your proof, I mean, you did a steep 180. Color was good. Wasn't so pleasant on the back end. But your proof was 95.7.
No way.
Nailed it, Doc.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Now let's move on to Team Outlaw. Frank, you operate like Mark and I do. You know, redneck ingenuity. And putting that spark in your wood, that's exactly what that is. Your flavors were complex. They were deep. We gave you a hallmark of 95, and you went to almost 102. But all in all, fine drink.
Thank you, sir.
Curtis.
Yes, sir.
Deep, rich flavor. I mean, you brought it. A good finish start to end. You struggled a little bit with your clarity. There again, the hallmark we set of 95 proof. You fell a little short again. You were at 79 proof, which is just under that threshold. But all in all, fine job. Congratulations.
Kelly, it tastes good. It looks good. It smells good. You're a little bit off on the proof, though.
I got in my own head.
Your proof came out at 99.2. Outstanding job.
Thank you, sir.
Outlaw, legal kicked your hind end on proofing. So it goes to show that legal side can work without instruments. So kudos, guys. You know, we tasted a lot of great liquor today, and as an added challenge, we asked you to bring us a jar at 95 proof. In our world, you know, at the end of the day, flavor is what brings customers back for the next jar. So we had to use flavor as the top indicator for the jar that we chose. And I tell you, it was a very, very tough decision.
Unfortunately, it involved the task that one has to go away from each side. But unfortunately, GP, Curtis, y'all didn't make the cut, and we're going to have to ask you to step out.
Gentlemen, thank you so much.
It's been an honor. It's been an honor and a privilege to judge both of you all again.
Trent, when I was watching you work, I was like, I don't know about this. There's some room for error here, but I think you delivered exactly what you told us you were going to. I thought it was a nice, bright, grape, ginger beer flavor. A little light on the alcohol.
I would have liked to have seen a little bit more alcohol myself. I think you need to change your shirt. You need to put grapes all over it. I don't know how you got so many grapes in that can. I'm telling you, it is grape, and it's great.
Thank you.
Michaela, you described it as if you'd scraped the bottom of a peach cobbler and then drank it. You underestimated that. It was beyond that. Peachy, yeah. Bitter, yeah. Everything was right there, perfectly balanced.
I thank you. Played your bitter hand very well. That's a touchy, touchy line right there. I didn't really get peach cobbler, but I did get a peach sour, and it was very pleasant.
Kelly, you said the sissy sour. I didn't see anything sissy about it, nor was it really sour. It was just a good, flavorful, fresh fruit drink, front to back. Nothing missing anywhere in between.
You still holding the record for the most alcohol in the jar. You still putting it in there. You didn't take too much out, but you added a lot of flavor to it. It balanced out. It's smooth. You can probably tell. We wanted to drink more of it.
Great.
So you brought that Outlaw out.
Thank you.
My man, Frank.
Sure.
Blueberry
pie.
Pie. Blueberry, very good, not overly sweet. Your alcohol is still good level. I think you may have introduced something to a different market entirely. And I don't think that was your goal, but you know, some of the best things in the world often come about by accident.
Yes, sir.
What we started with yours, there was like an off note. At first, I was like, I don't know about this, but it was something I never had. I just respect the heck out of that.
You've heard all we've got to say about all this. I know in my eyes, and I'm sure the rest of my cohorts up here feel the same way, we don't have any losers here. Just two people can only advance. Mr. Trent, Frank, your all's cocktails brought you a ticket home. I'm awful sorry, and we'll have to ask y'all to head on out.
I'm a little bit shocked that I'm going home from my cocktail because I made a really beautiful drink. And I think I may even, you know, look at turning my drink into a legal drink at this point.
I came here to win at this time. And unfortunately, I didn't. But I feel no shame whatsoever. I'm coming back.
And this is not every day that this happens, that an outlaw and legal come together as happy as you are, both of you. Very special, and should be proud of where you're standing today.
So here we go, Michaela. Flavor. I'm telling you, it's all in there. Finished dry and leveled off well on the palate front to back.
Michaela, great job. And it's a really smooth drink. A little different on the nose. The nose wasn't really what I expected. And, you know, maybe it's because raisins. You did a wonderful job running your still. You're not used to a thumper, but I think that you've acclimated yourself very well to one.
So, Michaela, and your proof is really, really good, outstanding. I like it. Real clear jar, and it tastes really good.
Great job.
Thank you.
And we come to Kelly, the wildcat in the bunch.
You didn't run a lot of jars, but, you know, this contest is not about quantity. It's about a good turn-in, drinkable jar. It's what it's supposed to be. Really great nose, a little lower proof, but it carried through well. Lower proof usually brings a lot of flavor, and it did.
You knew exactly when to make that cut. I mean, it was just pow. You know, you knew when you got into that 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 was a grappa.
Kelly, your proof is a little bit lower, but you bought flavor, and you bought the perfect jar that you thought was the best jar, and I think it tastes really good.
Thank you.
Fine job on both y'all's parts. All right, guys, the dirty deed, I guess, if you want to put it, falls to me. And, you know, normally it does really bother me, but, you know, I've spent a lot of time with you two, and I know that whichever direction this goes, that you two are at peace in your souls with that. And we had a long talk this morning. I told you about that water coming down the hill. All the men that I knew that had made liquor out of that water. And, you know, Cock County was the moonshine capital of the world, not because of the quantity they made, but the quality. And, you know, you guys get to put your names on that list of people that have run liquor off that water at the foot of that mountain right there. I mean, there ain't too many people that's gonna get to do that anymore. So think about that. That's a badge of honor in and amongst itself.
It's never an easy job here, but there can only be one tournament champion.
And Kelly, you are that next master distiller. Congratulations, young lady.
I am happy over the moon. You know, being the winner of the first master distiller, where it's two women at the end, I just want to inspire more women to get into this industry and to trust themselves and to be taken seriously.
Ain't that good?